probably look very much like the moon. Recent investigations suggest that many millions of years later, it was subjected to a long period of heavy bombardment by asteroids and comets. It now seems very likely that the oceans and most of the elements that make up the atmosphere were delivered to the Earth during this later bombardment. Even the chemicals from which life itself originated may have arrived at this time. Comets, though now much fewer in number, continue to cross the orbits of the inner planets. As 1979, for the first time, a comet was seen to fall into the sun. The sun controls the movement of every element in its system, the planets, moons, asteroids, and comets. Mercury, the planet closest to the sun, must travel at 48 kilometers a second to stay in orbit. Lower, and it too would fall into the sun. Further from the sun, Earth can safely travel more slowly, 30 kilometers a second. 10 times further out, Saturn moves at less than 10 kilometers a second, but still balances the sun's gravitational pull. Even further out, moving at a very, very slow orbital speed are the countless low-density fragments left over from the creation of the planets. Often referred to as dirty snowballs, they are made up of a mixture of stony material and the ice of frozen gases. Where the sun's gravity is almost non-existent, their orbits can be easily disturbed. The slight gravitational pull of a passing star is enough to influence the low-density fragment. It leaves its orbit on this distant edge of the solar system and falls inward toward the sun. Thousands of years, it accelerates along its new path. As yet, it has none of the characteristics which we usually associate with comets. To become more comet-like, it must first escape the gravity fields of the outer planets. It is thought that at least half the comets that penetrate this far are diverted and thrown outward again by their influence. The comet which comes through soon begins the gradual transformation from cold lump to luminous apparition. It begins to reflect sunlight. As the heat increases, the frozen gases vaporize to form a coma, a brilliant sphere expanding for thousands of kilometers. In the unresisting near vacuum of space, the pressure of sunlight forces the gas and dust into a radiantly glowing tail, stretching for millions of kilometers. The tail always points away from the sun, the source of the pressure. The tail has two parts. The smoother part is sunlight reflecting off dust particles. The irregular part is light given off by electrified gas. This is somewhat like the display of northern lights or the glow in a fluorescent tube. When the comet makes its closest approach to the sun, the erosion of the icy surface is most intense. Expanding Finally, after a few months of exposure to the ravages of the sun, the blasted nucleus moves away into the colder reaches of space. While most of the material drifts off along the orbital path, a small amount may settle back to the cooling surface. Most comets follow long elliptical orbits which bring them back to the sun every few thousand years. A small number return after only a few years. These are the short period comets. Because they spend more time near the sun, they decay quickly. When all the frozen gases have evaporated and been dispersed along the orbital path, the stony pieces in the nucleus may separate. The core residue, still traveling the old orbit, but too small to reflect much light, finally disappears. There could be many such clusters of material from decayed comets still in orbit. A comet named Encke is a short-period comet. It appears dimmer each time, every 3 years, 4 months. Twice each year, in June and November, the Earth passes through the dust particles dispersed along its orbit. They are revealed as a shower of meteors or shooting stars as they burn up in the atmosphere. In space, there are a number of stony objects which cross the orbit of Earth. They are called Apollo asteroids. It is thought that some of them may be the burned-out, rocky remnants of short-period comets. Earth-threatening asteroid could be changed. Only a moderate amount of energy would be needed to remove any risk of collision. Although it appears only once every 76 years, it's classified as a short-period comet. Its passage has been recorded as far back as 240 BC. This is Halley's Comet. It was last visible to the naked eye in 1910. By 1948, it had traveled more than 5 billion kilometers to reach its furthest point from the sun. It has been on its way back toward the sun and us once again. Present estimates indicate an object about 5 kilometers in diameter. Its rotation could be anything between 10 and 50 hours. In October 1982, its reflected light was bright enough to be seen by a powerful telescope trained on its predicted position in space. It was still 1,600 million kilometers away. As on every previous passage, it begins to experience its brief period of incandescence. Avoids the gravitational influence of the outer planets because its orbit brings it up from below the plane in which the planets revolve only when it is close to the orbit of Earth. November 1985, its closest approach to Earth, heading sunward. February 1986. Its closest approach, the sun. The solar system in a spectacular display across the sky.